choice.
That I ain't going
nowhere.
I ain't blowing no smoke. I mean, I've been sober, but you should've known it. I wasn't going.
What's up, booze? What's up, bass? As y'all can tell by the title of this video, this is just going to be a watch me do my hair video. It's not a tutorial because I'm not really going in depth. I'm not showing too much, but I'm still just going to be talking about my process and what I do. So basically, this is my braid down that I'm doing, and I'm doing a very simple braid down, straight to the back, connect the braids. And I want a middle part, so I'm going to try my best to get a middle part, like, in the middle of my head, because I always struggle with that. I probably got, like, a moving scalp or something, but I can never get it in the middle of my head. But basically, I'm just going to come in and tell y'all what I'm doing along the way and let you guys kind of watch, and I'll play some little vibes, you know, along the way, so... So now that the braid down is done, I am slicking back my edges, of course. I don't want to get any type of lace glue on them. And I'm also going to spritz them down, or you can use holding spray or whatever you want. I'm just going to use some spritz and, you know, mold them down. And I don't use no blow dry or anything. I just kind of fan it so it can, like, air dry and have, like, a nice seal over it. And then I put it on a cap. That is not even a word. I put on a cap. I did not use a ball cap method because I wasn't planning on keeping this wig on for that long. I really just wanted to get a video out. You know, content. The girls, they get it. But yeah, so I'm putting this wig on and kind of like adjusting it, making sure the part is in the right place for me. And I'm reusing this wig or reinstalling it. So... you know, I just want to make sure that everything is in place because, you know, after you use a wig, things can be out of place. So then I roll it back so I don't get no flyaways in the glue. And this is the glue that I'm using. I like this brand. I believe I got this off Amazon. Like, it was like a, you know, highly recommended Amazon brand. I've been seeing it in videos on TikTok or whatever. So I'm going to do like one or two layers of this glue. Like I said, I wasn't keeping it on that long. So like one to two. And I want it to dry clear before I stick the lace down. So I'm going to smooth it out real even. Okay, now my glue is dry, and sorry for the camera quality, by the way, because I don't know what the heck happened in the process of editing this video. I guess it just wouldn't upload properly. So anyways, yeah, so I'm just going to stick that lace into that clear dry glue, and I'm placing it exactly where I want it on my head, and I'm just kind of like using a little bit of pressure, not stretching the lace too much, but like just a little tiny bit. And so it can really like stick in that glue and stay and have a nice hold. So yeah. I'm just using that hot comb to make sure that, you know, no flyaways is going to be on the glue. And I'm not going to put the band on just yet. I'm going to let it dry a little bit. That's the trick to not getting that white stuff on your lace and getting a good melt, is letting the glue dry all the way. Don't spray it. Don't do nothing. Just let that glue dry. Stick that lace into there. You know, make sure your parts and your edges is precise. and let that glue dry. Because if you don't, y'all actually going to see what's going to happen. Because I let it dry, but I ain't let it dry long enough. I probably should have used the blow dryer on a cool setting or something. But yeah, y'all going to see. I'm also trying to be careful and go slow because this little electric hot comb get hot. And you don't even know it until it's like burning you. So I'm checking the lace. Make sure everything is stuck down. This is the lace spray that I'm using, the melt spray. All of it is the same brand that I used except the wax stick. I do have a wax stick from them. I just didn't open it yet and use it. This is what I'm using for my baby hairs. I like this mousse. I just found this off of TikTok too. So I tried it out and I think I'm going to keep using it. I really like it. It's not oily or anything. And it gives my baby hairs that look that I want. Like that edge control look. I like that. I don't know if y'all like that, but I do. Even when I comb them out, they still look precise, basically. I'm just going in making sure that they look exactly how I want them to look before I throw on a lace band. And I did this off camera, but I also kind of use that edge brush with a little bit of mousse to like tame any little flyaways. And then I'm fanning it because this is the part that I said I maybe should have used the blow dryer, you know, on cool setting. But I just kind of fanned it and let it air dry. And I definitely should have dried it longer. Y'all are gonna see why in just a minute. But again, the same brand, the Mielle or whatever it's called. I literally don't know how to pronounce this. Miele, whatever. I'm going in and just pressing everything out, making sure everything is flat, making sure the hair, you know, lay where I want to on my head, you know, as far as the wig. I wore this wig before, so, you know, I'm just making it flat. And fixing my part, I don't know if it was because of the black cap underneath, probably the black cap, but I couldn't really see the definition in my part like I wanted to. So I went in with some concealer that is my shade, maybe just a little bit lighter than me, so I can match my scalp tone and, you know, put that on the part to make it look a lot more natural. Pushing that in, and yeah, using a hot comb to flatten that out. Put every hair in place, baby, not a hair out of place. If y'all want the link for it, let me know in the comments. So I'm going to take the lace band off and I'm showing you right here why you need to let it dry. Y'all see that stickiness? I'm so mad that in the process of editing that my quality messed up, but y'all couldn't really see it that well. It wasn't too bad. All I had to do was lay it down with the comb and it was okay. And then to like offset that little bit of whiteness that was still there, I just went in with some foundation that is the shade of my face and just, you know, kind of blended that to make it look, you know, melted, give the illusion of scalp. And now I'm finna press the hair out and I just went in with my bare hair flat irons. I forgot which ones these was specifically, but let me know in the comments. I'll find it and link it. But yes, it's looking slayed. It's looking melted. So I just want the bone straight look. This is my dog, Biscuit. He was acting a fool. Put him down. But yeah, so my bed head flat irons are great. They give you that one swoop, especially if you do the chase with the comb. And I'm not using a steel comb or nothing. I'm using a plastic comb, but it's a professional styling comb, so it's not gonna melt. You know, look at this wig, y'all. Look at the hair. And it's 180 density. I think it's a 28 inch. I can't really remember, but I will let y'all know if y'all want to know. And then I didn't want just like completely straight after I seen it. I'm like, let me add a little flip to the front. So I'm going to do that. Here go me straightening the other side. The same exact gist. You know, chasing with the flat iron and the comb. Just to get that bone straight look and that one time pass through. Because I don't like constantly flat ironing my hair. That's how you make your hair stink and stale and all of that. So, here I am. Separating the hair. Yeah, y'all see it. And I beg you, do not forget to flat iron the back of your wig. Like, literally, y'all be walking around with big old humps in the back of y'all hair. And all everybody is still beautiful either way. I don't care what your wig look like. But if you want to be that girl, a it girl, or just, you know, be on better on top of your game with your hair, flat iron the back of your hair, you know? This two-piece pink jumpsuit that I got on by Juicy. I love it so much. It is so comfortable. I just love Juicy. If you love me and you ever wanted to give me anything Juicy, I will love. I will literally, like, probably cry. To finish up and put everything in place, I use this Ebon wax stick. It smells so good. It smells like coconut. And just look at my hair, y'all. It's so cute. Y'all cannot tell me that ain't giving scalp. Thank you guys so much for watching. Bye.